Good afternoon. I'm Larry Hawley here for WGN News Now. We are taking live the introductory news conference for Chicago Fire FC's new manager, Ezra Hendrickson. He will be the 10th full-time manager in the history of the club. He comes to Chicago after being a lead assistant coach for the Columbus Crew. He was there in 2020 when the club won the Major League Soccer Championship. And he comes over here hoping to bring the Chicago Fire back to success after a number of years of struggle. As you've said, the club has not made...
This is WGN News Now.
As I was saying before, the club has really struggled over the past few years. They have not made the playoffs since the 2017 season. They were not close this past year, mainly out of contention almost the entire time. So Ezra Hendrickson, the 10th manager in the history of Chicago Fire FC soccer, is being introduced right now. Let's get you to that news conference at the moment, right now. Hendrickson is introduced as the new manager.
Several hundred applications for this job. So all this doesn't make it easy because it takes time. It's very time consuming to narrow it down. We did this in several steps, and every time we spoke to Ezra, we were left with a very good impression afterwards. And ultimately, we invited him to come to Chicago. We met, we spoke again, and in the end we spoke for 2 days, I think, and then to finally find out that this might be a good fit. I am convinced that this is a perfect fit for the Fire. I would also like to take the opportunity to thank my colleagues, Sebastian Pelzer, our technical director, Alex Bowler and Eddie Rock, who were so supportive in this whole process, who were very active and who also gave me the confidence to go through this. Ezra, a very warm welcome to our club. We are really happy to have you here as our new head coach with all your knowledge that you have of the league, of the game. You are a real football mind, a bit obsessed like many of us, and I think this is something we need. It is a privilege to have you as a coach in this club. Welcome.
All right. Well, first of all, thank you very much, George. Thank you guys for being here and welcome me to your city. For those of you watching on Zoom, sorry you can't be here, but thank you also. I'm very honored to be chosen as head coach of this team. I have a lot of people to thank. First, I want to start by thanking the owner, Joe, and his family for entrusting me with this duty to be the head coach going forward for this team. It's a very historic team, prestigious club, and so I'm very honored for that. George, Sebastian, Eddie, Alex, these guys who've helped me along the way, who's with me during the interview process. I want to thank them for also having faith in me as far as leading this team going forward. It's a great city, like I said. I'm happy to be here, and I'm really looking forward to great things here in Chicago. I think we have a good foundation, a good core group of players, one of the things that attracted me to the club is being able to work with these players. You know, I've worked with young players a lot in my time as an assistant coach, and I'm looking forward to that, as well as building the team with some additional players. So it's great times. I'm happy, I'm excited, and I hope you guys are excited, and the fans are gonna enjoy what this team is gonna be about going forward. It's gonna be some growing pains, but just know that we'll get this thing right and get this team back to where it belongs. And that's to be one of the top teams in this league, because like I said, it's a big soccer city, and we need to make sure that our fans enjoy that that entertainment style of soccer that we're gonna bring here starting next year.
All right, thanks gentlemen. We'll now open it up for the Q&A. Media members here in the room, please make sure to state your name and outlet into the microphone so Ezra can get to know you. For the media members who are with us virtually, hit the raise hand icon on Zoom, and we will we'll unmute your line, and it's your turn to ask a question. With that, let's start with Jeremy.
Hi, Ezra. Jeremy McCullough, Chicago Tribune. First of all, congratulations. And you touched a little bit on growing pains, and this is the fire team kind of undergoing another rebuild after going through one in 2020, and it's a club that hasn't won a trophy since 2006. So why take on this role knowing the challenge ahead of you, and how do you hope to tackle that challenge?
Well, when I look around the club and see the people who are in charge of changing the course of this club, I was very encouraged. I think they have very good soccer minds. And who knows the league, who knows what type of players are going to be successful in this league. When I came in and spoke in my interview process, I told them about my philosophy, my style of play, and the type of players that, you know, I would be looking to work with and to bring into the club. And they were in alignment with that, those things. And so I think there's a bright future for the club. Like I said, the core group of players, you know, when you look at Chicago, a lot of people talk about the Phillies and the Dallas when they talk about homegrowns and having, you know, very good young players. But I think this club is right up there with those clubs as far as, you know, that pathway of homegrown players coming through the first team. And so that was very attractive for me. And I just see a lot of potential. And it's an opportunity that, you know, I wanted to take and you know, go forward with. But like I said, you know, having an owner like Joe that's, you know, invested so much and is willing to invest so much is also a big factor, because if you don't have that backing, then it becomes difficult. You know, I've been on several teams. I've been involved in this league now for 25 years, either as a player or as an assistant coach. And I know that it takes an owner with that vision and that resource and willing to help out in that aspect for the team to be successful. So when you put all that together, the soccer minds that's running the day-to-day operations, and you have an owner like that, you have a city like this, and the type of players that we have currently, it's exciting times for me, and I'm just happy to, you know, to be here and to be in charge of getting us where we need to be.
All right, next we'll go to Brian Sandalo on Zoom. Go ahead, Brian, your line's up.
Sure. Hi, I'm Brian Sandalo with the Chicago Sun-Times. Nice to virtually meet you. You've worked under some of the best coaches this league has ever produced, Ziggy Schmid, Caleb Porter. What have you learned from them, and how are you going to apply some of those lessons with the Fire?
Well, I've learned from some of the best. You know, I spent most of my years as a player or as an assistant coach with Ziggy Schmid. And then we worked under Brian Schmetzer, and then most recently, Caleb Porter. And these are guys who have been very successful, who've won championships in the league, and who have been leaders of very successful clubs. So I'll take a lot from each one of them, but at the end of the day, it's gonna be what I've learned compounded with what I bring to the table as far as a coach and my style and my philosophy that's gonna lead this team going forward. So I'm very grateful to have had, you know, those experiences and learned from, as you say, some of the best, most productive coaches in this league. So I think when you put that with my knowledge of the game and how I like to see the game play, I think it's a good base and a good foundation for me to start this process and begin my new career as head coach.
All right, we'll stick with Zoom and go next to Sam Stachel. Go ahead, Sam.
Thank you, Jamie. This is Sam Stachel with The Athletic. Thanks, George and Ezra. Congrats to you, Ezra, on the new position. Ezra, you've talked a little bit about your philosophy. You've obviously been in the league a lot. You've won a lot of trophies. The trophies that you have won and the teams that you've been a part of that have won championships, they've taken different approaches to roster building. I'm curious if you think, you know, what your kind of ideal approach to building a roster is. I know you're the coach and George is the sporting director, GM, so that's not exactly your purview, but I'm sure you'll be involved in it. So what is kind of your ideal approach, and how much do you value kind of league experience? We've seen teams around the league that are still playing, New England in particular, rely heavily on that and have a lot of success this season in particular.
Yeah, well, I think it's going to be a collaborative effort. Once we get together, I think, like I said before, there's a lot of soccer minds here in Chicago currently. And with my experience and being around successful teams, I'll bring that to the table. But it's not going to be so much, you know, what I want to do. It's going to be a collaborative effort. Now, someone has to make final decisions, and then ultimately it usually lands on the head of the head coach. So But it's going to be taking input from all angles. We have guys like Frank Klopas that's still on staff, that's embedded into Chicago and this club, and we're going to look to guys like that to help us, form a team that's competitive, a team that's competing for trophies year in and year out. So it's going to be a collaborative effort with input from myself and the sporting guys and my staff once that's all put together. But I think we have enough talented soccer minds in this organization to make this team very formidable.
All right, continuing with Zoom, we'll go Justin Wasik and then Tom Bogert. Go ahead, Justin.
Thanks, Jamie. Hello, George and Ezra. Congrats, Ezra, again.
Thank you.
So obviously, I know you were focused on your job as an assistant coach with the Crew last season, but from the games that you played versus the Fire and maybe any film that you watched both in the season and in preparation for your interviews, what are some of the things that stuck out to you in regards to things that you think need improving the most moving into your first year as the Fire's head coach?
Well, first I want to say that, as I'm going to repeat that, we have a lot of good young talent, but sometimes you need leadership and you need someone to kind of help bring in those players along, a sort of extension of the coaching staff, because as a coach or as a coaching staff, you don't really sometimes have all that it takes to help with young players. So I think maybe that some leadership, there's some issues that might need fixes as far as in the locker room. But like I said, we are working right now currently to bring some guys in to help nurture these young players in. And then we have guys like Bernstein here who, who are great leaders who we're going to look to help, bring along the young talent. But it's a process, and we're doing a lot behind the scenes to improve the team in that aspect. But I think that's one thing we need to improve, because the team is so young and a lot of inexperienced guys, is to make sure that we have a good mixture of experienced guys to help bring the team along. Because like I said, it's going to be growing pains. We want to win every game, but it's not going to happen that way. But you need leaders in the locker room when things aren't going so well that can, lift guys up and say, hey, come on, let's go. That's something that, we've been started the process of looking at bringing in additional help to help the core guys that we have currently.
Tom Bogert?
Hey, Jamie. Congrats, Ezra, and nice to speak to you both. This one's for George, though. If you can kind of get into the head coach search process a little bit more, what specifically about Ezra stuck out as him being the best candidate for this job, and how many final candidates did it come down to?
We ultimately had three finalists in this process, and Ezra was obviously one of the three. You understand that I won't mention any name, that's clear. What stood out, I think the whole assessment was not easy for the candidates because we had some tricky questions that we asked, and he did great in all the interviews that we had with him. He really did great, be it tactically, be it also, when you hire someone, you want him to be hungry for this job, and this was a feeling that we all had, that he's very hungry, that he's very keen on becoming our new head coach. This was also very, very important for us. And then one thing that I always say in such processes is I always try to be in the shoes of a player, and I ask myself, could this guy motivate me as a player? Would I run for him? And I'd definitely run quite far for Ezra.
All right, we'll go to Jeremy next.
George, Jeremy Akula, Chicago Tribune. After largely focusing on international talent in the last two off seasons, does hiring a longtime MLS veteran like Ezra kind of indicate maybe a shift in philosophy that there'll be a greater emphasis on domestic talent?
Not necessarily, and I I do not completely agree, Jeremy, because when you see our homegrowns, for example, when you see how many homegrowns we have signed, then you see that we absolutely also bet on domestic talent. It's just, with all the regulations in this league, it's not so easy to get talents from other clubs that really help you getting better. This is a little bit a problem that we have, because it's not a free market like in other leagues in this world. But we are open, you know, it doesn't matter where someone comes from, and we want to have the best fits for our team. And if the best fit comes from a competitor, then we try to get the best talent, but it's not that easy. And we are at the moment working on signing new players. We already signed a player 12 months ago, almost 12 months ago, John Jado Duran from Colombia. Young striker, we will definitely focus a little bit more on experience in this off-season, that's for sure, because I completely agree with what Ezra says. We need more leadership in this group. That's something that is obvious.
Pat McCraney on Zoom, go ahead.
Hey guys, Pat McCraney from SB Nation. Ezra, congrats to you. I guess either one of you guys can answer this. When we last spoke with Georg, he had mentioned that there were three players that he was kind of waiting for the new coach to provide input on before the club decided what to do with. That was Wyatt Omsberg, Jonathan Bornstein, and Gaston Jimenez. I wonder, you mentioned Bornstein a second ago, Ezra. I wonder if there's been any decisions on those three, and Ezra, what you thought of those three players.
Let me answer first. I think it's not the moment to speak about the roster. I think it's the day where we welcome Ezra to this club. He has already spoken about Jonathan Bornstein. This also means that you can be sure that Jonathan will be with us in the next season. But I wouldn't want this to be a media conference about our roster. We will inform about the roster at a later stage, once we have really taken decisions on most of the players that are here, or most of the players who will come or who won't come to our club.
Brian Sandalo?
Ezra, this is for you. You know, you're assistant for over a decade, a glittering playing career, but you hadn't gotten the full-time head coaching job until now. Was there ever a point where you kind of thought it might not happen? And just emotionally, what did it mean for you to finally reach that goal of being named an MLS head coach?
Well, I'm a very confident individual. Everyone who knows me knows that. And so I never once thought, you know, this will not happen. I just knew that I had to keep working hard. I believe in hard work. And I just knew that I had to keep working hard and that one day this opportunity would present itself. Ironically, it was my first time being interviewed in person for a head coaching job. So I just always prepared myself and always envisioned myself being in this position. Never once did I waver. Never once did I, you know, felt like giving up as far as being the leader of a team in a head coaching position. I always thought that the opportunity would come, and I always prepared myself that when it came, I would be ready for it. And that's the case right now. I feel very ready and just excited to get started and to just, you know, bring what I can to a team, my experiences, my successes that I've had to lead this team back to prominence.
Sam Stasko.
Oh, sorry, I forgot to lower my hand. I didn't have anything, Jamie. Apologies.
All good. We'll go next to Justin Wasnik. Go ahead, Justin.
Thanks, Jamie. This one's for Ezra again. Ezra, obviously every manager that ever manages needs their first gig. Everyone always has a first gig. This is yours at the head coach level. So what do you say to those who maybe look at your lack of managerial experience? I know you have a vast experience coaching and playing, but again, no head coach experience at the MLS level. What do you say to those who maybe are a bit weary that you don't have any head coach experience at this level yet?
Well, I think there are always going to be detractors. I don't really focus too much on that. I'm a very positive guy. Maybe that's from being Caribbean. We just have a positive attitude about ourselves. So I expect there be some people who will maybe say that, but I think for the most part, anyone who've seen me play, seen me work with me, know that I am ready. Yes, I have not had MLS head coaching experience, but for 3 years I did coach Sounders too. So I got some head coaching experience there. I know it's not the same, but from my years of playing and from my years as an assistant coach and being in successful environment, I think I bring a lot to the table. So it's just a matter of being patient and, you know, I would say to those detractors, show up to the games starting in February and you will no longer be a detractor.
All right. Thanks, Ezra.
We'll go Alexander Zigic and back to then Brian Sandel after that. Go ahead, Alex.
Israel Alexander Zegas, Chicago correspondent for Radio TV Serbia. I was wondering, would you like to get fans in Chicago more excited about soccer as a game? It seems that in most countries of the world, soccer is automatically number one. But Chicago, for example, there seems to be more excitement about basketball, baseball, football, and how to get fans more excited about soccer as such.
Is this for me?
Yes.
Well, I'm a big believer in you win, and people will get excited, and people will come to games. We are going to play a brand of soccer that the people of Chicago can, that resonates with them. But at the end of the day, you can play beautiful soccer all you want. If you're not winning, it's going to be difficult, especially in a city like Chicago with so many other things going on, so many other avenues, so many other sporting events, so many other attractions that people can go to. If you're not winning, they're not going to come. And we hope to be winning. There are going to be growing pains. I keep going back to that. But we're going to win more than we are losing. And so I think at the end of the day, being successful is going to bring people to the stadium and keep them coming back to the stadium. And that's our focus going forward with this team, is to be very successful and get our fans back to being engaged in this team and lifting trophies. My biggest mentor, Ziggy Schmidt, that was one thing he always said, you know, is fill the trophy case. You know, wherever you go, fill the trophy case. And that's something that we plan to do here in Chicago.
Brian Sandel?
Ezra, with your hire, I believe now there are three black coaches in Major League Soccer, which to me seems like a very low number. What do you think this hire means from that perspective, both other black assistant coaches, future, you know, black players who might want to become coaches someday, and also the black fans who look at that number and think that's a pretty low number, that there's three black head coaches now in this league?
Well, I'm happy that I've worked hard to get to this position, first of all. So I'm very elated, very excited to have my hard work pay off eventually. I do think that it's a great thing to have minority leadership in organizations, because I think sometimes you're not represented as well as possibly should. But for me, if any coach of my minority standing can see this as aspiration, see this as something to look forward to, and then that's great, because I think there are some great minority coaches out there. So if I can be inspiration to any of these coaches, that makes me happy, and that helps me feel better about, you know, being here now. Because, like I said, having minority leadership in organizations is a good thing for all organizations. So I'm just happy that I've worked hard to get this opportunity, and if it could inspire others to continue and work hard and not give up hope and believe in what they're doing, and then eventually they too can be in this position.
All right, we'll take one more on Zoom. Justin Wasik, go ahead, your line is open.
Thanks. This is either for George or Ezra, whoever wants to answer it. Growing pains have been mentioned multiple times in this presser. But at the same time, Ezra, I think you were the one that said, you know, especially in a great sports city like Chicago, you need to be successful to get fans in the stands. So this year, for the 2022 season, what does success look like?
Thin ice. I feel like every year I say the same thing, but of course we want to make the playoffs. Of course, because otherwise we do not even need to start training in January. We want to make the playoffs. It's difficult to predict anything at the moment because we don't know who will be available and who will not be available for our team next season. In the playoffs, I think this we experience again these days, anything can happen. If you have a good day, you can go far. If you have one bad day, your season is over. That's can be terrible sometimes, but definitely we want to make the playoffs.
All right, any other questions in the room? All right, well that will then move to the quick photo opportunity with George and Ezra.
You have heard there from new Chicago Fire FC manager, head coach, whatever you'd like to call it, Ezra Hendrickson. He takes over the Chicago Fire as the 10th head coach in the history of the franchise, doing so today at a news conference here in Chicago. A couple of the things that we heard a lot about, one thing that Hendrickson said at least a few times, and very simply and very correctly, is this is going to be a process and there's going to be growing pains. You expect that from a franchise that got rid of 9 players at the end of last season, and also is dealing with a lot of young homegrown players who saw a lot of action in a 2021 campaign where Chicago Fire FC, very frankly, was not really in the playoff competition for most of the season. A couple other things that he mentioned, which I think was a bit of a surprise. This is the first time he ever had an in-person head coaching interview in Major League Soccer. That would come as a surprise since he's been in the league not only as a player for 12 seasons where he won 3 championships, but also as an assistant since 2009. He was with Seattle Sounders FC and then eventually took over as the head coach of Seattle Sounders 2, which is their USL affiliate, essentially their next step down affiliate from the Major League Soccer Club. He was the head coach there, also had a year of experience with the LA Galaxy as well, also doing that. Along with his coaching as an assistant. That was in 2018. In 2019, he joined the Columbus Crew. He was there in 2020 when they won the Major League Soccer Championship. Ezra also won a championship as a member of the Crew as a player as well. So Hendrickson takes over for Chicago Fire FC. He does so as the 10th in the history of the club. As he said a couple of times, he likes the young talent that are on the roster, but at the same point, he does understand that he's got to bring in new leadership. He mentioned leadership being a big key for young clubs that are trying to find their way in Major League Soccer, and frankly, that's what Chicago Fire FC is doing right now. For you hardcore members, of course, fans of the franchise, you might have heard Jonathan Bornstein, a veteran defender. It was Hendrickson who mentioned him a few times. He's one of those guys still on the fence about possibly returning to the club next season, so you heard some good things there. It looks like he's going to be back. But again, expect a number of new faces to join those homegrown players, the Brian Gutierrez's, the Gabriel Sloninas, those who saw heavy time in the second half of last season. They'll be there along too as Hendrickson starts to build up Chicago Fire FC. And we mentioned the challenge that he'll have. The club has not made the playoffs since 2017, and they have not won a postseason match since 2009. The only other time they made it before that, 2012, they were in the knockout round, which they were in 2017 as well, and were eliminated very, very quickly. So Ezra Hendrickson is the new manager of Chicago Fire FC. It was announced before the Thanksgiving holiday, introduced today to the Chicago media. Be very interesting to see what moves are made to build his first club. Again, the season gets going right away. March 5th, will be the opener at Soldier Field. They will take on Orlando. That is the earliest opener for the Fire in the history of the club. We thank you very much for tuning in to Ezra Hendrickson's news conference and introducing him as the new head coach of the Chicago Fire. You can check out more coverage of his news conference, more of what he said. And if you want to get some background on Hendrickson, you can go right now to the Chicago Fire FC tab on the sports page. A full bio is there from his hiring last week. I'm Larry Hawley for WGN News Now. Hope you have a wonderful day and continue to tune in for more news throughout the afternoon. Take care.